So this morning we are heading further up north to Kerikeri in the Bay of Islands.
And we are going to check out the Rainbow Falls and the oldest building in New Zealand. So we are on our way toward Kerikeri right now. We are going to stop at a beautiful place called Rainbow Falls and a very typical and authentic place called the Stone Store. And that is going to be our activities today. We're going to be doing two things, not just one, two things.
Since Robin broke his arm a couple of days ago, he is the one in charge of the directions while I am the one driving. And we are heading to Kerikeri, which is our first stop in the Bay of Islands.
Kerikeri is really up north in the Bay of Islands. It's really famous for its fruit growing industry. There's heaps of backpackers working fruit picking in the area. Plus, it's one of the earliest settled places in the country, but we're not here for that just yet. We're here for the beautiful waterfalls. Yep, I know what you guys are gonna say, yet another waterfall. And yes, there is heaps of waterfall in New Zealand, and Northland is actually a prime spot for awesome waterfalls too. After the beautiful Whangarei waterfall, we now check Rainbow Falls.
So this waterfall is actually bigger and delivers more waters than the Whangarei Falls do. And on top of it, if you can see behind it, you usually can actually just swim and climb around, and you can actually hang out behind the waterfall, which is really cool.
There are three different viewpoints to Rainbow Falls, and the first one is from pretty far away, so you can get the whole scale of this grand waterfall. And then the next viewpoint is right from above the waterfall, but when we're actually making our way to this next viewpoint, we spot quite a lot of really cute little birds in the trees.
No, I just spotted a bird.
This bird is a fantail, which is one of the most common native birds in New Zealand.
All the beech trees provide a great environment for the fantails because there is a lot of moss dangling from them, which are a shelter for insects, which fantails actually just feed on.
After spending way too much time filming this little fantail, otherwise known as a pi waka waka in Maori, we finally make it to the second viewpoint of Rainbow Falls, which is an awesome perspective from above.
This waterfall is pretty gigantic. It's quite amazing to see the huge amount of water flowing through it. And I'm pretty sure it's gonna look even better from up close. So I'm passing the barrier and go check out the waterfall from even closer. That's probably because I'm doing those silly things like that. I end up breaking my arms all the time. But from behind the waterfall, I get to see heaps of stuff, including the ducks, which are the local wildlife, as well as some freshwater fish. It was definitely worth the hop.
Is there a sign saying you can't go through that?
The fences imply it.
I don't understand the subtle hint. I understand big, bright, red signs. Yeah.
But there is one more viewpoint of the Rainbow Falls, which is definitely worth checking out. It's about a 5-minute walk down to the base of the waterfall. And to be quite honest, if the Department of Conservation says it's 5 minutes, it's probably about 2 minutes. So that makes it a total round trip of 5-minute walk, definitely worth it to check out where the waterfall plunges into the river. The track is super well maintained, and as planned, it doesn't take us long to arrive on the viewpoint. And we know we're there because every single plant surrounding us are drenched in water. This waterfall is creating so much water, it's crazy.
The Maori name for Rainbow Falls, Waianiwaniwa, means waters of the rainbow. It basically means the same thing. And this is probably because there's so much spray coming off this waterfall mixed with the sunlight that it probably creates a rainbow. So we walked down to the very bottom viewing platform to check this out for ourselves. But unfortunately, we don't see any rainbow, so what are you gonna do? Nevertheless, there's plenty of native forest to check out, and this whole area is regenerating kauri and totara forest, which are some of the largest trees in New Zealand. Another thing you can do here if you're feeling adventurous is to actually climb behind the waterfall itself by crossing the stream and going around the back of the falls. However, Robin's arm is way too freshly broken for us to do that sort of adventuring today, so we just take our time making our way back up the track back toward the car park. The Rainbow Falls car park has a load of picnic benches and different seating areas so you can set up a picnic there, and that's exactly what Robin and I decide to do once we get back and before we move on to our next activity of the day, which is going to be the Stone Star and the Kemp House in Kerikeri. Although we're driving there, there is another way to get to the Stone Star in Kerikeri, which is just taking the walking track from Rainbow Falls for about 1 hour until you reach the Stone Star alongside the Kerikeri River.
Believe it or not, this Stone Star is actually one of the oldest buildings in New Zealand, and it was in trade 170 years ago. That is very old in terms of New Zealand history. It has a lot of original building supplies, and it was an amazing place back in the days. That was the center of the whole local economy. This place was actually the base of the Kerikeri Mission Station, and we learn all about that in the museum. There is a lot of really interactive exhibition, which is really cool because it makes the whole history things much easier to digest when you can play around with it. The Kerikeri Mission was the base for all the early settlers that were coming to New Zealand to spread the word of God. They were coming here in the country to convert to Christianity a lot of the local Maoris, and they made Kerikeri their base. But getting back to the store, it was a hot spot for buying everything you needed as an early settler. You could buy food and rations, you can also buy all your building supplies, as well as everything you need to create a whole new village. And speaking of villages, we are actually heading toward New Zealand's oldest surviving house. It's the Kemp House.
Māori desperately wanted European settlements nearby. It meant that they had access to tools, trade and technology.
This house and this settlement was one of the central areas for all Europeans in New Zealand.
Our guide Shannon is dressed in old worldly clothing, really looking the part, and giving us a guided tour of this house that was built in 1821. And it gives us an amazing insight in how the early settlers lived. Shannon tells us stories of how the Kemp family used to live, as well as how Kerikeri was one of the first places where the Maori invited visitors to live among them. And one of those visitors were the Kemp family that occupied this house.
Nora, I just said she really liked the
walls.
I
actually like the decoration.
No,
edgy.
You don't.
It's like...
We get the time to have a look around the house ourselves and check out all the early settler artifacts, including these really creepy dolls.
I swear, those dolls are staring at me. They are. Ooh, that was really creepy. This is the end of our Kerikeri road trip, but there's heaps to do in the area, so we are checking in the Honeheke Backpackers as we're going to stay here for a few days.
What does it want from us? Why is it here?